So this group, which is I am going to present, is nothing but it's called as the CDIP group, which basically carries a lot of entrants every year. This year also we are proposing around 16 entrants for the software quota, rather software quota plus the institute quota, both mix 16, and around 6 for the embedded. So around 22 people I am going to select if I found suitable. Now we are going to present you what exactly CDIP group is, why the name CDIP is. So CDIP basically stands for, is a Center for Distance Engineering Education Program. So basically it is a distance education program department, and then it has got a different type of activities. So these are the different activities what we do in general. The first of all, these are the portals or these are the websites, you can also refer later on also, in which you can see the first one is the courses on view. It is something equivalent to the, I don't know whether you have referred the NPTEL website or what, where the courses are being recorded and the archived courses are available. The second one is the ResearchScope, which is more a research oriented thing, where on the archival of the PhD student have put what kind of research work they are doing, what kind of work they are doing, and the research related people who have got the interest into the research activity can visit ResearchScope website and can see how exactly the things happen in IIT Bombay. Last portal that has been mentioned is the Ask a Question. Ask a Question is an initiative of IIT Bombay wherein we normally address the questions of the student every week. Every Thursday in electrical engineering, when I say electrical engineering in terms of IITs, it is electrical, electronics, instrumentation, power electronics, everything has been covered under the electrical engineering. And on Fridays, we address physics. So electrical and physics, these are being two departments who actually answers questions every week, which has been asked by the children across the country. So all the people who are available in this area can ask the question and IIT Bombay faculties answer to it. And this program is running in its 7th year. So it is a long 7 years history available to this. Then recently in the morning, Professor Pathak has also mentioned, we have developed one more product which is called as e-guide. So the e-guide is a product we have developed, and it is being launched last week into the National Museum, Delhi. I have been communicated this morning. The Prime Minister also liked it and wanted to scale down nationwide. So this basically is again the creativity or the development which happened in the same group. Now the type of technologies we work with. So these are the different technologies. Almost to all different segments we cater to it. If you can see, there is a PHP, JSP, Java, which is being the scripting languages or the programming languages. Then the Drupal, which is under the content management. Then the Android, Windows. These are the OSS, databases, MySQL, Python, shell scripting, graphics. All we have got a huge amount of umbrella available wherein we cater to different technologies. But how to go ahead, how to stand in front, and how to cater to the things. So we have come up with a certain amount of options or the opportunities at this summer. I always say people, while selecting a project, don't select the project or group based on how the presentation has been given, what the contents are, what kind of technology the project have got, how good the idea is. I always suggest student to select the project based on your own capabilities, your own skill sets, and your own interests. The reason is that many times what happened, if you didn't match to this, you become the baggage for that particular group. If suppose you like something new, good in a mobile communication area, you selected the thing and you get selected also, you have been offered also same project, but you don't know anything in the area of the mobile space, what will happen? The other guys who are working on the mobile area, you will become a piggyback. They have to carry you throughout the project. So don't do this. Go to that particular project only wherein you have got interest and you have got skill sets, right? So let's see what we are going to offer this summer. These are the few things that we are going to offer you this summer. In the languages, we have got a PHP, JSP option available. Deliberately, my presentation will take you in a such a way that so that you will be very easily map yourself with the type of requirements and the available options with you. And then you can better choose what exactly things you are going to take. So this is the PHP, JSP is the languages which are available. Python is another option available. Then there is a Java, AngularJS, JavaScript, jQuery. These are the Java family available. Then there is a embedded C, and C++ is for the embedded people which are being interested in working onto the embedded. Then on mobile space, you can have Android, and the Linux also is also one of the option. And then OpenCV, WebRTC, these are the other things. In databases, if you can see, there are MySQL, SQLite, and there is a NoSQL also we use somewhere, which is Redis. There are a few servers we are thinking of. One is the Nginx, another is the Kuranto, and then the Node.js. So these are the typically servers which is being utilized for the applications we are working on. And then the engines. So these are the few engines which we have offered this summer to you people. Now in the engines, you can have the Unreal, which is basically virtual engines. Then WebRTC is the real-time communication engine. Then Maya is a graphics engine, and OpenGL. These are different frameworks on which we expect the students should work. YII, a standard framework for the PHP programming. Then Django for the Python, Bootstrap for the front-end designing, AngularJS, and TensorFlow is basically the framework which is used for the deep learning. So we'll come to that also later. Now how to select, how to decide, what are the options available? So these are the basically options, what are the type of projects we have available this summer. The first option, the group is the software, and the lateral two are the hardware. The first one is that the implementation of the WebRTC on mobile platform. Now basically when we say WebRTC, the technology basically is being developed for web-based real-time communication. But the WebRTC people have come forward and they have again developed the advanced module, and now it is quite possible that we can use the WebRTC on the mobile platform. So this summer we are trying to use this WebRTC to actually work on the mobile platform. We are expecting mobile platform as an Android, and based on Android, we want to develop the WebRTC application. This is the project number one. Project has got the complexity medium to high. The reason is that WebRTC putting onto the mobile devices is initially a little tricky. We are expecting four people who has got the specialty into the Android, Java, and object-oriented programming background can very well work on this. Next is the content management system. Now everybody, I think that most of you are aware about the Drupal. There are n number of content management system available. Drupal is there, Joomla is there, Daisy is there, JLibrary is there, WordPress is there. N number of project handling tools available in different content management system. Is it possible that we can develop our own content management system? So the first question is, why to use Drupal? Why should not you have got your own content management system? Because if you see nowadays, these all content management systems are becoming very, very heavy. They are giving 10 options, out of which you required only 2 or 3. So can there be a possibility that we can have our own customized content management system? And the answer is yes. So you can have your own something which is equivalent to Drupal or Joomla or whatever. So we are expecting to develop a content management system which is based on the YII framework in PHP with the MySQL as a database. And we are proposing that there should be the 4 entrants which can work on this to develop the thing. Next is the deep learning. Now Deep learning especially is the concept which came in the space of artificial intelligence. Now, deep learning basically is the approach which is being used more on GPU. So, everything what we do is on the CPU. But now the trend has came that your GPU is more powerful than the CPU. So, people are using the GPU power to complement to the work of the CPU. And the deep learning is one of the application which is a very booming and new technology which is very popular. Is called as the deep learning, wherein on GPU using the ANN, that is the artificial neural network, a intelligent problem can be solved very well. So here we are proposing image processing kind of application which can be done under the deep learning. The platform which is being used is the TensorFlow. This is the framework on which the deep learning can be done over a GPU, and the language for scripting can be used Java or Python. So we propose Java because I know very well there are a lot of people who know Java rather than the Python, but both the options are available. Complexity is little high, and we propose that if 4 people can justify this task. Next is mocap. What exactly mocap is? Anybody knows mocap? If you don't know mocap, in a single click you will understand what is a mocap.
Hum logo ko samajh sako to, hum logo ko samajh sako to, samjho dil bhar jani, tu tu main lafda jhagda apni yahi kahani, kabhi kabhi hum saath chale aur kabhi pila de pani. लेकिन अपने लोकतंत्र की ये है खूबी पुरानी, क्योंकि दिल है हिंदुस्तानी, क्योंकि दिल है हिंदुस्तानी.
सो दिस इज अ वेरी कॉमन टाइप ऑफ एनिमेशंस वी सी एवरी डे ऑन द टेलीविजन्स, राइट? दिस इज सो सॉरी वेरी फेमस कार्टून एनिमेशंस व्हिच इज बीइंग शोन रेगुलरली बाय द आज तक. हाउ एग्जैक्टली दिस एनिमेशंस आर डेवलप्ड? You may have seen that the incident happened, and next day or the same day also you can find the animations on the television. We know very well creating animation is a very tedious job, time consuming job, frame by frame you have to design and then manage and create the content. But mocap is a technique by which this can happen very fast. So that is why we are also proposing project to develop this mocap. What exactly they do that? They put the sensors on the human body with a dress having the sensors, and when I behave, the way I make the motions of my, the mocap name came from the motion capture. So that way I move, the skin of that particular puppet or the cartoon or the person automatically start moving. So it makes possible to create a real-time animation using the mocaps. So we actually want this summer to work on the mocaps and create the animation for the education, because students into the primary and the secondary schools are very much interested or very much fascinated with the different type of cartoons they like, they love. I know very well 80% of the people sitting over here very well know Doraemon. So that cartoon is so popular and in everybody's house. It is quite Nomita, Doraemon, these all cartoons or the characters are in everybody's house, and this can be created, or this kind of films can be created in real time. Nowadays, nobody draws the picture and then creates the animation, right? So mocap is one of the area whereon we want to work this summer. There are few new area technologies like the gaming engine and other things one has to work on, but that tricks and techniques we will teach the students. Now for embedded system, for mocap to happen, there is a necessity that one has to map the real time motion of the physical person with the virtual character, for which there is a necessity of managing, tracking the motions, for which there are sensors and hardware is required. So in the electronics or the embedded system group, we propose that there should be a group working on this who will create the motion data and transfer it to the system, whereas the software developed will process it and create the puppet or the move the puppet. So these are the two groups which are working together. One is from the hardwareal side and another is from softwareal side together. The other batch in the embedded system we are expecting to work on the IoT application for the local to global communication. Now IoT is quite common. So many days we are working on Internet of Things and all. But there are two different discrete areas are before us. One is short distance communication and another is the long distance communication. Short distance meaning thereby if I have got a Bluetooth, my communication limit is limited. If I have got IR, my communication limit is limited. So suppose I have got a set-top box which is basically controlled by IR-based remote control. I want to put it on the IoT. How it is possible? Suppose I have got a home theater system wherein I have got the Bluetooth wireless speakers available, but I want to control them on IoT. So now the shorter distance, that is what the name is like this, local to global. The local communication system can be integrated with the global communication system, for which we want to develop an intermediate layer, what we call it as a routing. So the local communication it will understand and it will integrate it with the global communication. So we want to come up with the such kind of intermediate layer which will integrate local and global together. So this is the other project into the area of embedded systems. How it will work? So basically working, this is the steps in which generally we expect people should work. First of all, we will set our expectations upfront. We will not change our target in due course of time. Whatever we want, we will explain in the beginning so that you should know the scope of the work, the way actually it should be done. Create a discrete modules. Suppose we have to do complete work, we will segregate into the different modules. And we will tell you this is a phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, how exactly it can be done kind of thing. Next, what we will do, we established a program parameter and the goal. How much goals you have to achieve, when you have to achieve, we will put the time also and assign the mentor and buddy to you. So for doing this thing, I personally also believe very much that your success entirely depends how exactly you are being guided. I know very well you are quite young, enthusiastic. If properly being guided and mentored, you can deliver miracles. We not only provide this infrastructure, but additionally, we will provide you the way to communicate or get support or remain in touch with us after the internship also. So it should not happen. This is not the association for only 30 days, 20 days or 40 days. But after that also, if you want to continue to work on the same project or the same area, it will still continue. This is how the work is being done. There is a project management system. This is we are practicing from years together. This is not the first time I am explaining this. Every year I put the same thing. So we have got a project management system in which the work will be assigned, a time will be assigned, and you have to submit your work on the repository. So whatever you have developed, you have to just submit it. And it will be monitored by your mentor, and if required, you will be given the correction, suggestion, modification, whatever. Now the mentors. Mentors, as I have mentioned earlier, is a very important parameter. And that is why we have strengthened the mentorship more than any other thing. So you will have different type of mentors available. Different type of, there will be a mentor associated with you, a mentor will be given to you. We have started from last year, the another cadre, what we called as the associate mentor. Now associate mentors are those people who have already worked with us as a summer entrance in the previous years. Every year we declare this associate mentorship and lot of our ex summer entrants apply for it and become the associate mentors. Especially those students who are interested in certain area and same area we are carrying out next year, then these people help you in solving your problem remotely. They are sitting at their own locations, but they communicate with you over Skype, phone, chat, mails, whatever, and they support you to carry on your project. The other cadre is that the external mentor. Now, external mentor are those people who are sitting into the industry. This year, some people who have accepted the external mentorship from the industry, which are also are the IIT Bombay students. Microsoft, Cypress is the embedded system giant. Then Monarch is the video and image processing company. And PayPal, everybody knows, is the web-based payment gateway company. So web-based. So these are the company from where people have accepted to externally mentor the student. Again, this mentorship and this communication happens as per the mutual available time and mutual convenience. Deliverables. Now, after giving those many things, what we expect from you, what you should deliver to us. A very basic thing what we expect is that follow the rules. On certain issues, we are quite strict. Because unless we are not strict, we are not able to get the results. Follow the discipline. That is why I was talking with you people. You have to follow the discipline. This is IIT Bombay. Forget about what you are doing at your own institute. But here you have to follow our own discipline. Be punctual. Respect all others. And then be a good moral character. And the important is work in team. Because independently you cannot deliver anything. If you have got a team, and then only with the team you can deliver the things. This is a very small picture which interprets what exactly the teamwork is. Hackathon. I know you people may have come across this word. Nowadays it is becoming a very popular buzzword, but every year we conduct hackathon. This is again the history of 4 or 5 years. Every year we conduct different hackathons, wherein people who are participating with us get a chance, if they qualify, to participate in the hackathon and learn or hack a different type of technology. There are few hackathons which have happened in the last few years, Firefox hackathon, Wikipedia hackathon, and this year also we have proposed hackathon. These are few photographs of the hackathon, the Firefox hackathon, the Wikipedia hackathon, and so on and so forth. With us, working is fun. I always believe that the working should be always fun. But fun doesn't mean that we should break the discipline. If you see the students working with us, there are a lot of activities which happen apart from their work. They are doing fun. We do a lot of parties. You can see these are the parties which is being arranged during the internship. And this way, I hope that people will enjoy the stay at IIT Bombay. It is not only working, but it is enjoying the work culture. I will display, show you a small film with the last few years student summer entrance feedbacks, and then we will take question answer if there is.
This journey started when I first got the mail that I have been selected for internship here. I was really very hopeful and very excited.
Initially when we joined, we have few interviews where I got to know how to improve my skill as an interviewee. Later on, we had to attend our weekly presentations where we have to present our weekly work, and that made me know how to strengthen my presentation skills so that later on I can step forward to my professional world.
This summer internship at IIT Bombay helped me to get familiarized with softwares like Rainbow and version management system like GitBits, using which I could maintain my code efficiently and complete my project in a professional way.
Mentor support that was provided to us was just amazing. Our mentors were ready to help us at every point of our project, whether it would be at daytime or even at the night time, they helped us.
The regular tracking of students about their work, their regular presentations in their area.
The labs were open all the time whenever we wanted it, and all the facilities which an intern would need here.
So this internship was a great platform for me to work upon the newer technologies. Like I worked upon the Unity platform, that is a gaming engine for me.
Earlier we thought that the internship is only regarding the computer languages, but we electronic students were given the internship regarding phonetic keyboard, which was surely a part of electronics group.
Throughout the journey, we had a lot of fun, lot of activities, some Wikipedia hackathon, some other activities, some other photo shoots, all these things, this made it quite a fun.
We were guided so well that whatever we wanted to do, we were exactly shown the path how to do that. And this was for technical, but at the end also we got to participate in hackathon. That was really a great experience, and also we got a party. So it's not only work, but it's like work hard and play more.
The Wikipedia hackathon experience was very, very good. It was the first time in my life that I experienced a hackathon, and I learned a lot being in with very huge industry professionals.
My experience as an intern in IITB was extremely amazing. Especially to be a part of Citigroup was a cherry on the cake.
I totally appreciate my decision of being in Citigroup.
Ultimately, Citigroup is all about dream, develop and distribute. And you get to realize that here.
Thanks for giving me this chance. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.